Kiss FM's The Scoop.
Bring the noise!
On my loco.
All you need to know.
Kiss.
So, I can see that Diana Maroa is opening up about life after being pregnant, rather after giving birth.
Yes. Our Diana Maroa. So, I wasn't sure what you're going to say next, sorry. So, Diana Maroa is actually opening up about postpartum depression. Something that I've actually realized is serious in the world. But yeah, she talked about how when she got having her first child, the daughter, she had postpartum depression because in as much as she had a nanny and her husband around, they were just there but they weren't doing much. She actually says that Bahati at that time coincidentally became such a busy man that he used to come late and leave early in the morning. So she didn't have time for herself, and every time the baby is crying, she doesn't know what to do. So that was a bit depressing for her, and Bahati was not, I keep repeating, Bahati was not there for her. But at least she says the second baby has been there. But Bahati was not, he was not there for her.
Is that what she said? He was busy. But you see, this is the problem sometimes. You can't have your cake and eat it too at the same time. The brother is providing for his family. Unfortunately, his work is making sure that he has to get out of the house early and come back late. I'm sure you've heard of families where they have an arrangement. The husband goes and gets the bread, the woman takes care of the children. This, I feel, is a similar scenario. Let him go get the bread, you take care of the kids while I'm trying to figure this thing out. Because she thinks the car she's driving, that house that he did for her, the interior, did he just take her out for a 30th birthday celebration? All that didn't come from leaves and kneeling down only. Brother, gotta work. Before we talk about Giuliani and Brenda, Queen Bey,
yes.
Talk to me about Ali Kiba's new song and how it's calling his wifey.
So I always say you never miss the waters till your well runs dry. Now,
how long did it take you to get that saying?
I've been practicing the whole day.
Yeah, that don't sound like you.
Look at me shining.
That, you know, the people who chuck sayings. You're not the person.
What are you trying to say, bro?
I'm saying is you're not the same chick.
I'm here to just give you Mushene. So, Ali Kiba, let me just laugh at him. Because when he had the babe, he was just busy treating her like a house help, you know? Any mutu is not a wife. But now that she's gone, he decides, I need to dedicate a song to her and let her know that even if I die, I believe the Lord shall connect us together. He even says, babe, when we said our vows, we said, till death do us part. But here you are leaving me, babe, please come back. Woo! Yeah, I'm just like, I was almost saying something bad. I was like, Ali Kiba, when you lost this babe, when you had her, I mean, you didn't take care of her. And now that you've lost her, you think a song will bring her back? That is so terrible.
You are the people that we talk about when we talk. Those social media in-laws that Vera Sidika is always mentioning. They're you. Who invited you into their marriage? No one did.
Them.
Who invited you as their marriage counselor? No one did.
Them.
In fact, you don't even have a certification to even cancel a cut. And you're here trying to show people who are married how they should be. See, if the guy wants his wife back, he has a right to ask for her back. And who told you that she actually left him? What if this was just a publicity stunt for this jam? And here you are, falling into the trap. Atta kumeandika on www.kiss100.kco.ke. Hey, Shay. Queen Bey is in the building, and I know you are so excited to talk about Giuliani and Brenda Wairimu because your eyes are just lighting up. Yani, if there's someone who lights up because of gossip, it's you.
Because of breakups anyway.
Gossip.
Let me tell you something. First of all, in that whole interview Giuliani had with Betty, he doesn't look okay, to be honest. And we had this discussion in the office and you're saying he doesn't look okay. I don't know if it's because of Brenda, but I'm more inclined to the part that I think it's because of Bob Colimo. But hey, rest in peace. So, back to gossip. Giuliani tells us, he shocks us. First of all, he shocked me because I didn't know. They've not been together for 2 years. I was like,
bro. So news in Africa.
Imagine. I'm not sure Juni Bestiako. Ask him, just like, what do you mean 2 years? And he says, but one thing he said at the end of that interview is, in his next relationship, he will learn how to give and not to keep receiving. Now, that is some juice. I was just like, But anyway, the thing I like about everything else is that Brenda Wairimu gives him the time to be with his daughter. And I think that's something we rarely hear. So he says he spent 4 days in a week with her, with the daughter. So he has a good relationship with the daughter. It's just that he's broken up with Brenda. But then again, I still emphasize, he said he will give and stop receiving. That is juice there.
I don't think that's juice. I think that's just something that is called smelling the carpet. If you've been in a relationship, whether good or bad, and it ends, it's important for every single person to reevaluate. You take stock taking. There's never one person who's bad in a relationship. I say this and I say it every time. If you come out of a relationship and you're blaming the other person for everything that went wrong, you are immature and you don't deserve to be in another relationship. Now you deserve to be alone. You need to be able to step back and say, okay, what should I have done better? What should have this person done better? So in my next relationship, what am I looking for? Or what am I looking forward to doing? What Giuliani has done is what any good man, any mature man, any real man should do. Take notes, Lily.
Kiss FM's The Scoop.
Bring the noise!
On my loco.
All you need to know.
Kiss.
Kiss.